Sir, Ram Rai, sir, are you ready?
சார், வெரி குட் மார்னிங் சார். ஐ எம் ரெடி சார். கேட்குதுல சார்?
ஓகே ஓகே சார், கரெக்டாக ஒரு 9:05 ஆரம்பிச்சிருக்கு சார்.
ஓகே சார், 8:55 ஆகுது. நான் 9:05 நான் ஸ்டார்ட் பண்ணிடுறேன்.
ஆ ஓகே சார்.
ஓகே சார், ஓகே.
திருமுருகன் எம்சிஏவுக்கு வந்து திருமுருகன். ஆஹா, எம்சிஏவுக்கு ஆக்சுவலா வர வேண்டியது வந்து அபுதாகிர். அவர் ஏதோ ஒர்க்கிங் டேன்னு சொல்லிட்டு வர முடியாதுன்ட்டாரு. ஆல்டர்னேட் பண்ணிட்டு இப்ப காலேஜ் எல்லாம் லீவா திருப்பி எடுக்கிறனாரு. இல்ல சார், பிக்ஸ் பண்ணிட்டோம், நீங்க ஆஸ் யூஸ்வல் தேர்ட் அவர் வந்துருங்கன்ட்டேன். ஆமா, ஆனா நேத்து முந்தா நல்லா இருந்தது, ஹெவி தான். கான்வொகேஷன்ல ஸ்டாலினுக்கு கௌரவ டாக்டர் பட்டம் தரது அப்படின்னு சரியில்லைன்னு பேப்பர்ல போட்டிருக்கான். தினமலர்ல வந்து ஆட்சிக்கு வந்து 200 நாள் தான் ஆகுது, அப்படி ஒண்ணும் அவர் ஒன்னும் சாதனை செய்யல. தினமலர் சொல்லுவாங்க பிஜேபி அப்படின்ட்டு ஒரு அறிக்கை கொடுத்திருக்காரு 4ஆம் பக்கத்துல. ஒரு சின்ன இசி எம்பிஏல வெற்றிவேல் பண்ணிட்டாரு, தெரியுங்களா? இவங்க மேனேஜர் எக்கனாமிக்ஸ் ராகினி எடுக்கிறாங்கல்ல, நான்லாம் 15 வருஷமா எடுத்துட்டு இருக்கேன், எனக்கு கொடுக்காம அவங்களுக்கு ஏன் கொடுப்பீங்க? சொன்னாங்களா இது பண்ணி? அது வந்து அவர் வந்து அந்த ஊசி போடுறதுல ரெட் கிராஸ்ல ரொம்ப பிஸியா இருக்காரு. அதுல அடிக்கடி ப்ரோக்ராம் பிக்ஸ் பண்ணிட்டு அங்கே இங்கே போறதுனால அவரை போட்டோம்னா நமக்கு டிஸ்டர்ப் ஆகுதுன்ட்டுதான். அவரு வேணாம் அப்படிங்கிற மாதிரி இருந்தா, பட் அவர் மேடம் அந்த பேப்பர் எடுத்துக்கிட்டாங்க எக்கனாமிக்ஸ், சரிட்டு விட்டாச்சு. அவன் போய் பெரிய இஷ்யூ ஆக்கி கண்ட்ரோலர் டேரக்டர் சத்தம் போட்டு நான் விசிட்ட போறேன், அன்னைக்கு விசி இல்லை இருந்தாலும் அச்சா போச்சு அப்படின்ட்டு. அப்புறம் எங்கிட்ட போன் பண்ணி நான் கோஆர்டினேட்டர் தான், நீங்க உங்க விருப்பத்துக்கு ஆர்பிஐ போடுவீங்களா அப்படின்னு எங்கிட்ட சண்டைக்கு வந்தாரு. சார் அப்படி இல்லை சார், அவங்க சூஸ் பண்ணாங்க, சரி அவங்களுக்கு ஆள் இருக்கும் பட்சத்தில் அவங்க இது பண்ணிட்டாங்க, நீங்க வந்து ஆல்ரெடி பிஸி, கொஞ்சம் பொறுங்க சார், அடுத்த முறை பார்த்துக்கலாம், என்ன ஆஃப்டர்ஆல் 3 செஷன் தானே அப்படின்னு சொல்லி திருமுருகன் வந்தாரா?
காபி வேணா? காபி வேணா?
Sir, shall I start, sir?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, you can start.
Okay, sir. Okay, okay. Okay, so very good morning, friends. I think you are all very fine. First, just I recollect the things which we discussed in the previous class, right? So, in the previous class, we spent our valuable time to understand the basic concept of statistics, right? So, we understood the meaning of statistics, definition of statistics, then uses of statistics in business, right? Then the functions of statistics, then characteristics of statistics. Then we understood about the measure of central tendency. Okay. So in measure of central tendency, we learned how we can compute the arithmetic mean for various type of data. So data are three kinds. One is individual data and discrete data and grouped data. Okay, so individual data means raw data, right, which is unprocessed one. Just it contains the numerical facts, okay, like 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, like that. So discrete data, which is having the frequency, right, and the continuous data, so where the data are grouped in class interval, like 0 to 10, 10 to 15, 15 to 20, like that. So then we learned different method, like shortcut method, assumed mean method, right? Then safe deviation method. Then we discuss about the kinds of statistics or branches of statistics, descriptive statistics and inferential statistics, right? So today, so we are going to discuss about the median. So median means it's a central value, okay, or central number, right? So we are going to calculate the median for all the kinds of data, like individual data, discrete data, as well as data are given in the form of the class interval. So as far as median is concerned, or computing the median is concerned for individual data, right? The first we have to arrange the numbers, or we have to arrange the given set of data in ascending orders, right? So then we have to count the number of right observation, right? So if it is odd, we may go with the formula n plus 1 by 2. And if it is even, we may go with the formula n by 2 plus 1. Okay, la. So kuduthirukka data va neenga vandu count first ascending order la ezhudhirukinga. Then you have to count the number of observation. If I think total number of observation is 5, okay, 5 is an odd number. So we have to go with the formula n plus 1 by 2. So 5 plus 1 divided by 2. So 6 by 2 is equal to 3. So the third item may be the median. Okay. In case if the total number of observation is an even number, okay, we have to go with the formula n by 2 and n by 2 plus 1. For example, number of observation is 6, right? 6 by 2 and 6 by 2 plus 1, which means 3 and 4th item. So we have to take in the third observation and fourth observation, then we have to add two items, then we have to divide by the two. This is about the computation of median for individual data. Okay, right. So now we are going to learn about computation of median for discrete data, which means where the data are given with the frequency, right? So friends, please understand that. So computing the median for this individual data is the easiest one, but so computing the median for discrete data and interval data, right? So we have to take some effort, as well as we have to give our 100% undivided attention to understand the concept. Okay, right. So to find the median of the following distribution, right? So x is given and f is given, right? So x are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and the frequency are 7, 12, 17, 19, 21. Okay, right. So for computing the median for discrete data as well as group data, so we have to calculate the cumulative frequency. Okay, so cumulative frequency in the sense the frequencies are accumulated, or frequency are cumulated, right? So first you keep the first frequency as it is, right? For example, if you see this problem, the first frequency is 7. So therefore, the cumulative frequency, the first cumulative frequency is 7. Okay, for obtaining the second cumulative frequency, so the first cumulative frequency is added with the second the frequency. So 7 plus 12 is equal to 19. So 19 plus 17 is equal to 36. 36 plus 19 is equal to 55. The 55 plus 21 is equal to 76, right? So likewise, you are expected to calculate the cumulative frequency. And finally, the last frequency is 24. So 76 plus 24 is equal to 100, right? So first, compute the cumulative frequency before finding the median for the given data. Okay, then, so we have to apply the formula n plus 1 by 2 item, okay? Here n is equal to 100. So as we discussed earlier, right? So if the data is individual data, so we have to consider the number of observation for n. Okay. Otherwise, right? So we have taken the total frequency as n. So please understand, guys, if the data is an individual data, which means the raw data, right? So for computing the median, either arithmetic mean or median, n should be total number of observation. In case, for example, in this problem, if the frequency is not given, so total number of observation is equal to 6. Therefore, n is equal to 6. But here, n is taken as 100, right? So because the frequency is given, so we have taken the sum of all the frequencies, because all the items are occurring 100 times, okay, right? We cannot say only one item is occurring 7 times and second item is occurring 12 times. We cannot say like that. Okay. So all the items are having the chance of occurring for 100 times. So the total frequency is 100. Therefore, capital N or either small n or capital N is equal to 100. So 100 plus 1 divided by 2 the item is 50.5. Okay, we cannot say the 50.5 is the median because in this value there is no 50.5. All right, so we are not going to find out the median in the frequency. So we are going to tell the median among the given variables, which means given x values, right? கொடுத்திருக்க x values ல தான் நம்ம என்ன median அப்படின்னு நம்ம சொல்லி சொல்லணும், right? So after finding the frequency, we are saying that the 50.5 item, right? So we have to check where the 50.5 lies in the cumulative frequency. So the cumulative 50.5 lies between 36 and 55. Friends, please understand. So we calculated the cumulative frequency, after which we find the median value. Okay, right. So then now we have to check. We are not finding the median. The value which you obtain, the 50.5, is called the median value. Okay, it is not going to be a median. So median means next we have to find out. Okay, so we just check where the 50.5 lies. So 50.5 lies between 36 and 55. Okay, right. So but it lies after 36. So definitely it lies before 55. So what is the corresponding x value for the 55? So her corresponding x value is here, right? I think look at this column. Sorry, look at this row, right? So cumulative frequency of this row is 55, and the corresponding x value is 4. Therefore, here the median is 4. Okay. So friends, please understand that. So the way of calculating the median for discrete data. Okay. Right. So now we are going to understand, right, the computation of median for continuous data. So in case the data are given in the form of the class interval, like 0 to 10, 10 to 15, or 15 to 20, right? I think, so ultimately, we are going to find the median for all kind of the data, but we are going to apply the different formula. Okay, right. I think for discrete data, you are going to use two formula, n plus 1 by 2 and n by 2 and n by 2 plus 1. In case if it is odd, you go with the formula n by 2 plus 1. If it is an even, you have to go with the second formula, n by 2 and n by 2 plus 1. Okay. Then if it is a discrete data, the formula is n by 2, n plus 1 by 2, right? So that's after getting that value, right? You have to check where the median lies, right? So now we are going to learn about the computation of median for continuous data, which means data which is given in the form of the class interval. So L is equal to N by 2 minus CF. CF talks about the cumulative frequency divided by F into I. That is not one, guys. It is I. Okay. So MD stands for median. L is equal to lower limit of the median class. Okay. So in the discrete data, right? So x values are given. X values are numerical numbers like 50, 25, 75, 88. Okay. So that value is considered as a median. Okay. But here we have to consider the median class because data are given in the form of the class interval 0 to 10, 10 to 50, like that. So, okay. So CF is equal to total of all frequency the before the median class. Okay, some class is going to be a median class among the given class interval. So the cumulative frequency in the sense, okay, we have to consider the cumulative frequency of previous cumulative frequency of the median class. Okay, so at the time of understanding the, right, at the time of doing the problem, right, we can understand that. I think definitely this material will be shared to you. Okay, then only we can learn.